there is a relation between electric current and the magnetic field, and for that relation we have already studied Biot-savart's law. But there is another method to relate electric current and magnetic field, and that was given to us by Ampere's. This is easier to apply, and with the help of this we can find out magnetic field in very complex situations where it was very difficult to find that with help of Biot-savart's law. So first we will study what was this Ampere's law. Ampere said that the source of magnetic field is electric current, of course. Now, how much magnetic field is produced by electric current? He says that without any complicacy, if current flowing in a conductor is I, let us declare that the magnetic field produced by this current is, the magnetic field produced by this current is I. Why to change it? He says if I is the current, then magnetic field is also produced, is I, by this current in this conductor. Now if so much magnetic field is produced, then where is this? Answer, we have seen the magnetic field is in the shape of closed circular loops. Where are these closed circular loops? Outside the conductor. Now there is a closed circular loop outside the conductor, and that is the direction of magnetic field. Okay, I will make it here. The current is going up, this is the direction of magnetic field. Now what is the strength of this magnetic field? For this, Ampere had a design. He said that the current flowing in this is I, magnetic field intensity at this is I. Magnetic field intensity is I, but where? In the conductor. The moment this magnetic field comes out, this atmosphere or the surrounding comes into picture, and the space does not allow the complete magnetic field to come out. Then how much it allows? We say that there is a characteristic of the medium which is known as permeability, and it allows magnetic field, it cut it short, it reduce it according to its characteristic of permeability. Then how much it is made? Answer, it is made permeability into I. And you all know permeability is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. That is 1 upon 4 pi upon 10 to the power 7. So much it is reduced the moment this magnetic field comes out. So magnetic field produced by current is I, but in the free space, this B turns to be mu naught I. And what is this? Permeability. Permeability of medium. If it is free space, then we put this naught here. Now, this is the magnetic field, the total magnetic field produced by this. Now, how do we count total magnetic field? This. For this, he says, this is a bit misnomer, this I should write total. Total. Now, how are we going to count the total magnetic field? He says that here, this magnetic field is captured by this loop. The magnetic field here has come out. I put a loop here, then this whole magnetic field is captured in the loop. Okay. If I want, I can also capture it at a larger loop here. If I want, I can capture it at this loop. So if I capture it here, then this is the magnetic field I am capturing. If I capture it here, then this is the magnetic field I am capturing. If I capture it here, then this is the magnetic field I am capturing. Now, the total magnetic field, first it was here at this point and its strength was mu naught I. Now, the same magnetic field has spread to this length. If it has spread to this length, then per centimeter or per meter, the magnetic field will become weaker, will become less. See, suppose we got a magnetic field equal to 100 here, strength 100. At this point, I find the strength is 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Total 100 is divided here. If I come to this loop, I find that magnetic field strength here is 5 because it is 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 100. How much magnetism was produced? 100. If I am distributing it here, it will be 10, 10, 10 per length. And if I am distributing it here, it is 5, 5, 5, 5. If I check magnetic field here, what I find that this magnetic field is only 2. It has got strength equal to 2 because this 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 50 times. Again, the total is 100. Here, the total is 100. And here, this is something larger, say 10 into 10. But how much is the magnetic field produced? 100. What is that 100? Mu naught I? Mu naught I, magnetic field total produced is 100. If I catch it here, then at every point I get it 10 because my loop is 10 centimeter. If I catch it here, at every point it is 5 because my loop is 20. If I catch it here, at every point it is 2 because length of my loop is 50. So he said the total magnetic field produced is mu naught I. And wherever you capture it, multiply this magnetic field, this one, or this total. If this total, which is produced, if it is divided by the total length, then what do we get? Magnetic field per unit length, and this magnetic field per unit length is how much? This is what we call strength or intensity of magnetic field. Now, intensity of magnetic field multiplied by total length. Intensity of magnetic field multiplied by total length. This gives total magnetic field produced. And how much is this total magnetic field? This is mu naught I and B into total length. How do we write total length in mathematics? We write it dl, 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 dl and closed integral of dl. Multiply with B, B. Okay, so we get this mathematical notation. Now, what is meaning of this? You have already understood that if there is a current flowing in a conductor, the total magnetism is mu naught I. This magnetism is divided through a large loop and the total length of the loop is integration dl. This is dl, 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 dl. This dl multiplied with B at this point. Here B will be weaker, here B will be stronger, more stronger, more stronger, because our length is decreasing. The total B is arrested within this small length. So at every point, this will be, B will be larger. So this expression, the total magnetic field calculated by this is equal to mu naught I, that is the current. This is Ampere's law. So now we will write the Ampere's law in words. It says, the this one name is given, we will call it line integral of magnetic field. Remember the name of this expression, line integral of magnetic field. Okay, so Ampere's law. Okay, look here, line integral of magnetic field in a closed loop is mu naught times the current threading through the loop. If I make this loop here and I want to find out what is the strength of magnetic field here, then this loop, the total length integral dl, this is to be multiplied with the strength B. This is line integral of magnetic field, because magnetic field is also in this direction. Even if it is not in this direction, we can make a dot product. Okay, then this total quantity BDL, known as line integral of magnetic field, this line integral of magnetic field in a closed loop, this is must be closed, not open from any place, is mu naught times the current which is threading through it. What is this threading through? You have seen embroidery. We put a frame, on the frame there is a cloth, and then we do the embroidery like this, threading. That thread pass through this cloth this way. That should be the nature of electric current when we are applying Ampere's law. You see, this thread has gone, has come out. So if the thread is going here, then we cannot apply Ampere's law. If the thread is passing here, we cannot apply. It must go through this, coming from one plane and coming out from the other plane. That is threading. So the current should be in that shape only, going in from one side, coming out from the other side. So that is the threading through. So this is equation of the Ampere's law, and with help of this we will find magnetic field for many different shapes at many different locations. Thank you.